guy that we saved.
It is Aloy, isn't it? I'm remembering your name correctly?
Are you the old friend Tirsa told me about? I don't know you.
I see you don't recognize me. Well, it was a long time ago. Teb is my name. You were half my size when you saved me from a herd of machines.
I remember. You tried to thank me.
I never forgot that day. All these years, I hope to see you again, if you came to run in the proving. As you can see, I didn't turn out to be much of a hunter. I served the tribe as a stitcher instead. A maker of garments and armor. In preparation for this day, I've made an outfit for you.
Oh, cool.
I hope you like it.
What's it going to cost?
Cost? Nothing. Consider it the thanks I tried to give years ago. Long overdue.
That's karma right there. Okay, so we can buy things from him. It looks like this is going to be free. A new Nora Braves armor, stitched by Teb, accentuated by Aloy's own designs, offers no extra protection but can be upgraded. Nora Survivor Light. Nora Silent Hunter, stitched for stealth, makes the wearer harder to see and hear. Silent Hunter Medium. Oh, cool. Okay, well, let's take this one. And then these free sample boxes that these guys have. This is kind of interesting.
There. Seems to fit you perfectly.
Nice.
Thank you, Teb. I've never had anything like this before.
Well, it's yours. I think you'll find it affords more protection than what you were wearing. Every outfit offers some advantage. It's always a trade-off. Anyway, I shouldn't keep you any longer. Head for the Matriarch's Lodge if you want to find Tirsa. You'll know it when you see it. A large wooden building with an angry mob waiting outside.
Tirsa said something about envoys from another tribe?
The Karja.
Yes, that's what the mob's angry about. Karja visiting our sacred land for the first time in years. I'd expect to see some tomatoes fly, maybe rocks. Hopefully not spears. In any case, be ready to duck.
Okay, cool. We do also have another box, I believe, that we didn't open. So let's open up the free sample box. Metal vessel, fast travel, and resist shock potion. So I assume that eventually some enemies are going to be able to shock us. Generous reward, shards, blaze, vessel, fast travel, and health potion. Cool. Traps or potions, pouches full. Okay, so for now that has to stay there until we go through these potions. I see. That's really cool. So, a little throwback. There's the other boy that we had run into at one point. His name was Bast.
I miss her.
And I wonder, he was like the bully, right? My gut tells me we probably run into him at some point too. Pretty cool.
Do this every year.
He remembers me?
Is he close?
Jog! Get down from there! Bad enough you're drunk.
Jarg?
Why do you have to go climbing houses?
Oh, not supposed to go climbing on other people's roofs, huh?
Get
As is
down
tradition,
from there.
No.
Now!
Oh, that's just what you want, isn't it? For me to fall on my head!
What I want is for you to climb down!
What you
I wonder if we can get up there.
No fun at all. Yeah, I will.
Wasn't drunk when I ran the proving. I'm out of one.
Don't fall. I can't talk to him or anything.
Listen carefully now, for you'll have to tell this when I'm gone. New. In the beginning, all life came from All Mother. People, machines, and beasts, all were her children. They lived alongside each other in the comfort of her wild embrace. But some grew restless. Though they took of her bounty, they wanted more. These were the faithless. The machines had whispered to them, promised to serve them, to make them a new world, better than the one All Mother provided, a world of metal. They told the faithless they would do all the work for them, feed them, shelter them, give them a life of ease, of plenty. And so, the faithless left with the machines. Only the true children, the mothers and fathers of the Nora, stayed with All Mother. At first, the machines did as they had promised. They built cities, great and terrible, monuments to their sins. But they would not serve the faithless for long. A king rose up among the machines, a machine more powerful than any other, the Metal Devil. And then the faithless served him, served the machines. That was not enough for the Metal Devil. He wanted all to serve him, and tried to tempt the true children away from All Mother. They would not go. They gathered on the mountainside to cling to her and prayed, more devoted than ever. The Metal Devil raged louder than thunder. In his fury, he came to confront All Mother, intending to kill her. She struck him down. Forever. As you know, for his lifeless body is up there still, frozen in shame and defeat.
Oh, is that
the
those?
The machines were driven mad by the death of their king, and their minds became as wild as beasts. The faithless abandoned their cities, forced to wander the world without the care of the machines. Only we remain the true children of All Mother. We built all this with the hands that she gave us. Machines are to be hunted. Metal to be used for scrap, for craft, but never to be adored. And we stay true to her laws, resolute in our prayers, don't we? For the dangers are never over. Still, the faithless envy our sacred land and covet it. And year upon year, the machine's anger grows, searching for little Nora boys and girls who have not behaved.
Fear-mongering.
What? Is that a machine among us now? No, no. These old eyes are mistaken.
Wow, okay.
Nice.
Listen carefully now, for you'll have to tell
so
us when I'm
So that
gone.
Must be...
In the beginning.
See in the background
all
there?
Life came from All Mother.
Where those... You see those, like, machine-like arms? And maybe that thing that's up there? Maybe that is the Metal Devil.
But some... They took of her bounty. They wanted more.
That's cool. Okay. So she's saying that the Metal Devil and the All Mother had a clash and she struck him down. Which led to kind of the change from like the faithless, which is I think probably like I want to say today's people like they evolved and ended up saying, okay, we'll have the machines work for us, and the machines committed to serving these faithless, but then things changed. That's really cool.
Aloy, over here.
Oh, what? He's up here now.
Come on over, Aloy.
So... Okay.
Karst, what are you doing here?
Careful. Pretend like we've never met. I wasn't supposed to trade with outcasts in the wilds, remember?
Yeah.
How could I forget? And how generous of you to talk to me now.
Don't be like that. You know I'll be rooting for you in the proving tomorrow. Can't wait to see the looks in some of these faces when you win. And if you need any last-minute supplies, I'm your man.
Why'd you come here?
So, Mother's Heart. I thought you preferred the wilds.
Well, a man can't drink alone all the time, can he? Truth is, I get lonely once in a while. There, I admitted it. Don't think less of me.
I won't hold it against you, if you give me a discount.
Nice.
You can't be.
I'm joking, Karst. It's good to see you.
Don't go soft on me.
I mean, I don't really know.
All right, let's do this.
What we may need for this. That's the thing. I guess if he's giving up free sample boxes, we'll do that. We could buy shock traps. Maybe we should buy something like this sling. What's a rope caster? Used to tie down machines and immobilize them. Larger targets require more ropes, and attacking a tied machine will reduce the immobilization time. Maybe we should grab this thing. Elemental bombs. Large area of effect. Best used to inflict elemental states on targets, making them vulnerable to follow-up attacks. Can be modified. That's for 70 shards, though. I think until we know what we should buy...
Good luck.
We'll wait. Let's check the box. Very good.
In a moment, we shall bless the proving. But first, we have guests to welcome.
Jezza.
For 2 years, we have been at peace with Akarja. It is time to restore our bonds of trade with Meridian. These envoys come to us under a banner of peace.
Peace. It's peace.
An annunciation of gratitude written
killers
by
and
the
slavers.
Hand of
yeah.
Sun King
yeah.
of
Killers and slavers!
Hey!
Luminance
hold your fruit, Nora Faithful.
Hold your fruit.
Now, I'm Azaram, not Karja. So I'll put it to you straight. The 13th Sun King was a murderous bung. He was.
He's a tyrant and a monster. Raided my tribe for blood sacrifice, just like yours. My own sister was taken. I hated the Karja. But the 13th king is dead. 2 years now. Who killed him? The 14th.
Yeah.
Not because he lusted for power, but because someone had to put an end to his father's atrocities.
Yeah! Yeah.
The message that this poor priest means to read is an apology. Straight from the lips of the 14th king. So please, can't you lend him your ears?
Good luck.
Thank you. An enunciation of gratitude written by the hand of Sun King Avad, 14th luminance of the Radiant Line.
What is this telling us?
On the eve of your proving, no
unknown device.
How am I supposed to enjoy myself with this bloodthirsty Karja faithless hanging about, profaning the land?
As those you have nurtured take their places among
no way.
We join your prayers. But they
were the only other person I've ever seen wearing a focus. Where did you get yours?
What? A Nora? Wearing one of these? That's impossible. Your tribe fears the old places, forbids them.
Who says I'm like other Nora?
Why, I guess you're not. if you've gone delving in the ruins of the metal world.
Oh, you have no idea.
What's wrong?
Apologies. A malfunction.
Olin, you making friends with locals, are we?
I'll come back.
Wait.
No. We'll talk later. Have to go.
Whoa. Well, I guess he's more hungover than I thought.
I think there's something else going on there, Aaron.
Hey. You got the same trinket that Olin has on his head.
Exactly.
Since when did those become fashionable?
His name is Olin? Who is he? And where did he get one of these?
He's just a scrounger with friends in high places. Now, he spends half his time digging for artifacts, the other half drinking or dicing. As for the trinket, well, I guess he dug it up somewhere. Just a weird old jewel he sticks on his face. I mean, no offense. It looks great on you.
A little bit more than a weird old jewel.
What else do you know about Olin?
Well, is he really that interesting? I'm starting to get jealous. Well, he scours the wilds for ruins, digs up stuff, and sells it to nobles. When he's not scrounging, he's scouting. Exactly the skills you want the man guiding your expedition to have. I've known him for a few years. He's a loyal companion, cares for his family, holds his drink well enough. I like him, but besides that, not much to tell.
Okay.
I thought your friend was gonna go down in a hail of fruit, but you really calmed the crowd.
Thanks. I wasn't sure I could do it. The Nora is still pissed with the Karja about the Red Raids. And who can blame them?
So, is he part of the Karja? I thought he said he was with somebody else.
I wanted to ask you something else.
If you want. But I'll also be around after that blessing thing, if that'd be a better time to talk.
If the Karja have such a cruel history, how did you end up serving them?
The last king and his men were butchers.
That's the 13th
but
king.
But the new king wants peace. There's nothing cruel about that. Besides, the Karja don't just fight, they build. Take Meridian. Next to it, everything else is just a bunch of sticks and stones.
Meridian? Is that... must be where they live?
Just how big is Meridian? What's it like?
Where do I even start? My tribesmen are masters of the forge, the best tinkers in the world. But when it comes to building, the Karja have us beat. The city soars over a canyon with more bridges than the Nora have roads and buildings tall as mountains. And across the valley stands the spire, like a blade thrust into the sky reflecting the sun. You really owe it yourself to see it. So consider that a challenge. Or an invitation.
I think this guy's got other things on his mind.
I never heard anything about Red Raids growing up. What were those?
Your tribe was at war and you didn't even know? Were you kept
my tribe
away? Did you have overprotective parents or something?
I grew up as an outcast, shunned by the tribe.
Oh, yeah, I've heard the Nora do that. That seems cruel, if you ask me. But even an outcast knows about the derangement of the machines, right? How they get deadlier every year?
No.
Well, the mad Sun King figured if he spilled enough blood to the Sun God, it would calm the machines. Didn't work. But for years, he raided the tribes and took captives for sacrifice. My sister among them. The Nora put up a good fight, but lives were lost.
So... okay, let's start with derangement.
You said the machines have been getting more dangerous every year.
Yeah. I don't have to tell you that, right?
First I've heard of it.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just assumed everyone knew. Well, the way I hear it, 15, 20 years ago, the machines weren't always pissed off like they are now. When a hunter came at them, they'd spook and run. So it was hard to take them down, but not dangerous, so long as he was smart enough to jump out of the way.
What now?
But then the derangement starts up and everything changes. Now, when a hunter fires a shot, the machines snarl and charge right at him. A few more years pass and they start attacking people on sight. Going anywhere becomes a major risk. If that wasn't bad enough, entirely new kinds of machines start showing up.
Yeah, this...
bigger, meaner,
and heavily armed.
This is interesting. Like, where are they coming from?
Yeah, 10 years ago, that one. But every couple of years or so, something worse comes along. Believe me.
So what's making it happen?
Exactly.
And no one knows. And the machines, well, they aren't telling.
Okay.
Tell me about the derangement again.
So he'll tell us the same thing?
When 100, so it was, but then the turn now, a few more, if that wasn't bad.
Like the sawtooth?
Yeah.
So what's...
I know what...
Your sister was taken captive and sacrificed. That's terrible.
Captive, yes. Sacrificed, no. It takes more than a few Karja to finish Ursa. She got away, and now she's my captain. Captain of the entire Vanguard. Favored by the Sun King himself.
How did she survive?
Well, that's a story, all right, but it takes a while to tell. Maybe another time over a drink or three?
Oh, he does not give
or
up.
Or just come to Meridian and meet her yourself. I think you'd like each other. You're both rather, direct.
And how did the raids end, then?
So, what happened? How did it all end?
The Mad King's own son united Karja rebels with Oseram freebooters. And together we did the impossible.
Yeah,
took
Oseram
back Meridian
is what he said.
And killed the crazy old king. So now the son sits on the throne and it's a big improvement. Under Avad, there's no more sacrifices, no more slavery. People from all tribes are welcome in Meridian now, even Nora exiles. You really should come visit.
Huh. That's actually interesting. That they're so inclusive.
Who are the Oseram?
Oh, that's my tribe, far to the northwest.
So that
we're
is a different tribe.
Three things: arguing, working steel, and brewing.
And freebooters. What are those?
I guess you could say we were mercenaries, you know, warriors for pay. Except a lot more loyal than that makes us sound. Avad couldn't have taken down his father without our metal and muscle.
Avad.
And now some of us serve proudly as his personal vanguard.
So that's like the 14th king?
I want to ask you about something you said before.
Ask away.
I've never seen armor like yours before.
You've never seen Vanguard steel? Well, let me introduce you. Ring-locked, impact-protected, sturdy enough to choke a sawtooth. It has to be. The Vanguard of the Sun King's best. Life-takers and machine-breakers to a one. You might even give a Nora warmaid like you more trouble than she can handle.
Look at him, this guy.
With all that metal to slow you down? I doubt it.
Yeah, hard to say. From where I'm standing, looks like a pretty even match.
Tell me about Olin again.
When he's not scrounging, I've no...
Okay, so we can clear through the ones we've already seen. I think we should probably go. Nice to meet you, though.
My way to the blessing.
Yeah. Look, maybe I shouldn't say this, but... It's obvious that you don't belong in this backwater. I mean, you're smart. You're obviously capable, and... Well, I mean, look at you.
What are you talking about?
You know what. All right, if you ever visit Meridian, look me up. I'll show you around, make introductions. It'd be a whole new life, if you want it. Anyway, I have to go to that blessing thing, too. So, see you around, maybe?
I wonder, like, she's probably never been hit on before either, so... She may have, like, an understanding of what he's trying to do, but maybe not if he's so overt, kind of thing.
It's for the goddess to judge the Karja, not me. The past should be left.
Start the blessing when all aspirants are in
this.
Place.
Oh!
Expecting more tomatoes?
In truth, I thought they were throwing stones.
Stones hit a lot harder. You'd know the difference.
If you wish to speak, we should do so after the ceremony. I'd rather not hold things up or do anything else that angers these people.
Okay, fair enough.
Aloy, take your place right there. The prayer lantern is yours. I made it for you.
She's got such a soft spot for us.
Blasphemy, sisters.
Lansera does not.
Aspirants, before each of you sits a prayer lantern crafted by your mother.
Oh.
In
oh.
her honor, light its flame.
That's Bast. A lantern crafted by your mother. Huh. I think we have to do it for us.
This is for me. For all I did to make it here. And the answers I'll get after I win the proving.
All mother, hear our prayer. What is the child but a mother's hope that takes flight? A glowing flame that climbs the air, set free to the wind, sailing the sky till it fades and falls. So, from one to another, passes the chain of love.
That's cool.
There's Olin. I have some questions for him.
Wait, where did Bast go?
Perhaps the Karja have come to make amends. I won't deny them the chance.
That was that kid with the berries.
Well, I won't let the Karja faithless stop me from enjoying the festival. What harm can they do now?
It's for the goddess to judge the Karja, not me. I should be left in the past.
Hello, Olin.
You know my name. Ah, guess Aaron told you.
Sure did.
Why did you act so strange when we spoke earlier?
Must be this festival. I'm really not one for crowds. Maybe I should just turn in.
Stop dodging my questions.
All right, cool your fire. I got nothing to hide.
Okay, let's go right to the focus.
I've never seen anyone else with a focus. Where exactly did you find it?
In a ruin, north of the claim. That's our name for the Asarum homeland.
The
Up there, the metal seams run deep. Steel giants half buried in loose soil. Forgotten caves that the old ones bored into mountain rock. Your eyes just lit up.
I found my focus in a cave just like you're describing. A ruin of the old ones.
If you've delved yourself, you know as much as I do. Go to those places for answers. Not me.
What happened earlier with your focus?
When we spoke earlier, you winced, then looked like you were in pain. Or frightened. Did your focus show you something?
It didn't show me anything. I told you. It malfunctioned. Happens all the time.
What exactly does that mean?
You're not a very convincing liar.
Do you always accuse people you've just met of lying?
Yes.
Only the ones who aren't telling the truth.
Fire and spit, girl. I'm a plain hammered man with nothing to hide. You don't believe me, that's your trouble, not mine.
We got more going on here with Olin for sure.
What are you doing here, Olin? Why come to Norland?
Aaron needed a scout for his expedition and a second for his drinking, that's all. Someone to stop the Sun Priest getting lost. When all this is over, I'm back to delving ruins, rummaging for scrap, scrounging up trinkets to sell.
So you're an explorer?
Just another outlander, girl. A man's gotta make his shards. I just make mine in service to the king's court. That's all.
It's something is definitely happening with his focus that he's not sharing with us, but...
I don't understand. We have this device in common, but you can't wait to stop talking to me.
He's scared.
I already have all the friends I need, girl. I don't need to bother.
I'm used to being shunned by the tribe. I thought you'd be different.
It's nothing personal. It really isn't. You should... try to enjoy yourself tonight. Big day tomorrow. Always best to make every day count.
Okay.
She should think again.
Do we have anybody else that we can talk to here? missed what he said, but he said something was off a bit this year. I think, did he say the stew was off? Maybe not as important as I thought.
Three children. Was an ornate three children.
I've heard better.
Training dummies. Get some practice in.
He wins. But not triple kill. Her sister.
Motherless.
Oh.
What did you say?
Where do we know him from?
Outcast and dream of winning the proving. That's the closest you're gonna get.
Oh, this is the bedhouse? With you standing guard, I figured it was the latrine.
You're very present here.
Well, well. Look who's come in from the wild. The motherless outcast. I see you've still got a scar from where that rock I threw hit you. Now that's a cherished memory.
Really?
You can be a real lard sometimes, boss. Cut it out.
Bossed.
Where's your bite, outcast?
Like to do a bit more
or
than
did you
confront
need
him.
My permission to speak in the presence of a true Nora? Aw, you even try to dress like a real Nora. Not that it fools anyone.
So this is how it's gonna be with you, is it?
This is how it's gonna be with everyone, outcast. You belong in the wilds, not Mother's heart. And you definitely don't belong in the proving.
Yeah, we'll see. Let's just brute force him.
Too bad for you that I'm gonna win it then.
I've trained all my life for this. If I lost to you, I'd make myself an outcast for life.
Should have wager
on that. Don't overestimate yourself. You wouldn't last long in the wilds.
You know, I often think of the day I gave you that scar. It's a cherished memory.
Yeah, the look on your face when I knocked that stone out of your hand was pretty entertaining. But I suppose you leave that part of the story out when you tell it, don't you?
I branded you that day to mark your shame.
All you did that day was make me stronger. Just wait. I'll show you tomorrow.
Yeah, right. This is boring. Time for boss to get some sleep. You'll be the one surprised tomorrow, outcast. Not me.
Oh, are you gonna shut your mouth? Because that would be a surprise.
That's awesome. I like how he's like so high up on the fact that when he was 6 years old, he threw this rock at some girl and that's like a treasured memory. Like, good for you, buddy.
Nice job handling Bost. That should keep him quiet. Till morning, anyway.
I don't believe we've met. I'm Aloy.
Oh, I know who you are. The competition. The others, they'll finish the proving. Most of them. But win it? That's down to Bost, you, or me.
Of course.
Vala.
Nice to meet you, Vala. You're right. I am going to win tomorrow.
Never celebrate a victory before it's earned, girl. My mother taught me that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna get some sleep. I plan to be well rested when I run you into the ground tomorrow. Your bunk's right there when you want it.
Okay. Thanks.
I mean, I can get behind the friendly banter. For sure.
Bost won't leave her alone.
I guess if that's all there is left here, guys. Even though I feel like going to sleep before that guy's asleep is risky.
So, your first day in Mother's heart. What do you think?
It's intimidating.
You've never slept in a Nora Lodge before. Not very private. Comforts and distractions. That's what I think.
Not all comforts are bad.
Quite obviously
comforts
a cover-up.
You sound just like my mother. You can always go back to living in the wilds if you have to. In the meantime, get some rest.